kid, has no season at all, and Frank Gore, who gained 1,695 yards last year, if they load up a bunch of people to stop him because they don't think the quarterback can hurt
Tony.
Him, they have to bring in another
Tony,
quarterback.
They had battle running the football.
You have to bring
Frank
in
Gore,
another guy.
You got Alex Smith. Come on. I'd like giving some gadgets, but not in that situation. That's ridiculous.
Beautiful punch by Lee. Burleson's taken him back this year from the 42. Well covered, came down, ball came out. Niners trying to scramble for it at the bottom of the pile. The initial signal is that Burleson was able to get it back. Now let's see what happens as they dig deeper. Yes, it is. Seattle retaining possession on a 53-yard kick that was returned six by Burleson.
Let's go back to that. Well, we can't go back to it now, George, but they take out the guys they depend on, and they basically give up on them.
Thank you.
Now, ESPNSoccerNet.com is available in French and German. Follow the great clubs of Ligue 1 from France and Bundesliga clubs from Germany's top league. On the French site, find a special section devoted to Les Bleus, where you can get the latest info on L'Équipe de France in addition to statistics and results. And on the German site, National Elf is featured with news and results about the national club. ESPNSoccerNet.com has all of Europe covered now in English, French, German, and Spanish. ESPNSoccerNet.com. Log on today.
Live NHL continues this Wednesday on NASN. Two Western Conference Giants meet in the Lone Star State as Joe Thornton brings his Sharks to Dallas to face Mike Modano and the Stars. Live NHL, San Jose versus Dallas this Wednesday only on NASN.
Seattle Seahawks leading 10-0. Seattle's wins over Tampa Bay, Cincinnati, at San Francisco when these teams met back on October 7th, and St. Louis, their losses. Pittsburgh and New Orleans beat them badly. The ones that they're having trouble living with, the blown late leads at Arizona and Cleveland. Hasselbeck, DJ Hackett off to the races. Out of bounds at the 4. It'll be first and goal. Gain of 48, Hasselbeck to Hackett.
Walt Harris took the gamble, number 27, tried to undercut Hackett. Terrific throw, great touch by Hasselbeck. You'll see the movement in the pocket. He finds Hasselbeck, arcs the ball over Walt Harris. Great touch on the throw. When you miss on that gamble, there's no one back there to help you. A lot of yards after the catch for Hackett.
Doing this without Dylan Branch as well. Don't even have their best two wide receivers out there, and haven't all year since the first game.
Marked out officially at the 6. To change the game to 46. Morris is the lone back. Hasselbeck waits for somebody, directs traffic. The hot shot high for Hackett. It'll be second down. Got down into the red zone earlier, unable to get a touchdown.
Boy, look at Matt Hasselbeck just move the ball around. Running backs involved, tight ends involved, and he is looking for the wide receivers. 11 balls to the wide receivers for 166 yards. The receiving corps right now having an outstanding day.
Meantime, Alex Smith has only completed 2 passes. Seneca Wallace has come into the game. The backup quarterback is at the top of the screen in the green shoes. Run with Morris. With the lane, Maurice Morris, touchdown, Seattle.
Gil Haskell, the offensive coordinator, does a really good job of spreading the field. Seneca Wallace lined up as a wide receiver, create seams for Mo Morris, and look at the vision right there. And he does have more quickness than Sean Alexander to find that seam, and he finds it and takes it to the end zone.
for Morris's first rushing touchdown of the season. Josh Brown tacks on his 19th extra point. Dominant performance by Seattle in the first 25 minutes.
From the people who brought you College Game Day and the worldwide leader in sports comes the biggest thing to hit college football in years, College Football Live, a new way to get your fix every weekday with breaking news, exclusive interviews, and packed full of previews and predictions. Get ahead of the game every weekday with College Football Live on NASN.
Like the med school scouts are out early today.
There are over 380,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of them will be going pro in something other than sports. Download the guide for college-bound students at ncaastudent.org.
Hey, owners. You know, you can get all your American sports fix daily right here on NASN, your channel for North American sports. Join me and this merry band of journalists as we chew up, spit out all the sports of the day.
Why do you stop breaking matches at noon?
Exclusively
on NASN. Hort,
cheerio, folks.
After the touchdown by Oregon's Maurice Morris, we remind you that Thursday night, the number two team in the land, Oregon, trying to keep Dennis Dixon atop the Heisman race and keep the BCS standings with Oregon in position to play the championship. They take on Arizona. We'll have the Pac-10 on Thursday night, so all of you across the country will get to see how for real Mike Bellotti's Ducks are. So note the start time, 9 Eastern for Thursday night football on ESPN. LSU and Oregon now at the top. Kansas keeps rolling in that Big 12 bunch at 3, 4, and 5 with a lot to play out.
If Kansas knocks off Missouri and then gets Oklahoma in the championship round, you don't think they're going to number one? I do.
I think they might. Get the BCS computers out. Get some of that Microsoft software you were talking about earlier. Returned by Maurice Hicks from the 14 to the 34-yard line. Here's what Monday Night Football sounded like 28 years ago tonight.
The quarterback with the rifle off, who has not been throwing that well tonight, but in his more recent efforts has begun to hit Carmichael, utilizing the height advantage that is Harris. Ron Jaworski.
Hasn't been throwing too well this far tonight.
Yeah. He didn't see the early net game.
Ron Jaworski, the Polish rifle, a little off tonight, but in the past has completed as many as 2 of 10 in critical situations.
Back to the game.
Good.
Jaws and the Eagles beat the Cowboys that night, 31-21. Gore runs to the right, only gains a couple of yards. That was 28 years ago tonight. Two TD passes to Harold Carmichael. You and Roger Staubach, the quarterbacks, you were both injured in the second quarter but returned in the third.
Well, there was a certain toughness to my game.
Roger Staubach.
I always beat up on Staubach.
You beat Roger Staubach. Wow.
You sound surprised.
Wow. I am surprised. That's why I sounded.
Staubach win the Heisman in the 60s?
What? Just a fact?
Yeah, I think so.
Another shot at Jaws. That's all right. He's giving up on you.
All right. Let's see if San Francisco can get a first down, huh? Second and 8. Smith pressured. Julian Peterson pulls him down by the jersey. Sack for Peterson, his 8th this year. And he's telling you his name's on his back, by the way. 4 of the 8 sacks against San Francisco.
Excellent job by Julian Peterson, staying after it. Moran Norris tried to block him, did for a split second. Julian Peterson got away and just stayed.
What happened to tearaway jerseys? He was almost naked at the end of that play. A tough night for Alex Smith.
You're being kind.
Third and 11. Move the pocket. Throws to Arnaz Battle. Can't stay in bounds, shy of the first down. It'll be fourth down. San Francisco punts, and here's Michelle.
You know, after a career-high 10 sacks last season, Mike, Julian Peterson acknowledged that last year was his best year as a pro, but he said he wanted to become an even better pass rusher. So to do that, he had to focus on the double teams. He felt that's where he was dropping off last year. So now he looks for those double teams coming. He decides which player he's going to attack, and he said, if it's a running back, I'm going to totally attack him because I'm going to win that battle every single time.
And he's done it against San Francisco for half of his 8 sacks. Puts him in the top 10 in the league. Andy Lee to kick it again. Delay again. And the play clock ran out.
Delay again. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
We mentioned Nate Burleson took a punt back 94 yards last week against Cleveland, tied a Seattle franchise record. We'll let this one go. And it'll roll out to about a 58-yard punt at the 6. Number one pick, quarterback, NFL draft. Since Peyton Manning in 98, of course, he went on to the Super Bowl championship last year. The next year, Tim Couch, almost the complete opposite result, now out of football after being taken number one from Kentucky. Michael Vick, 2 years later, number one overall, and we know his suspension problems as he went up and down with his playing career. In 2002, David Carr was the guy at Fresno State. He's obviously on his second team. Didn't work out with the Texans. And the very next year, Carson Palmer, who sat the entire rookie year for John Kitna, then went into play. Alex Smith, the number one overall pick, sat half of his first year, came in and took his lumps in the second half of that rookie season. Maurice Morris loses a yard there. Well, here are the guys after Carson Palmer in 03. Eli in 04, we know he's jumped in and continues his up and down moments. And after that, it was Alex Smith taken, and he has Bay Area company to have conversations about the struggles of being a quarterback in the number one overall pick. Because right across the bridge, Jamarcus Russell in Oakland, the number one overall pick in 2007. So
you know what stands out, Mike, after seeing that? It's a crapshoot. You really don't know. You get that guy number one in the draft, and you saw some really good ones and some really bad ones.
Hasselbeck from his own 5. Ingram is covered, just puts it away. Coming up on third down here.
You can say that, Jaws. You can say that it's a crapshoot. But when you have the number one overall pick and you want to invest it in a quarterback who is the front porch and face of your franchise, it shouldn't be a crapshoot.
Yeah, yeah.
You have a lot of people on the payroll studying these guys, and a guy shouldn't be cut from your team in 3 years and out of the league. That's an enormous mistake.
You're going to get me started in a subject that I could need an hour to talk about, but some of these scouts don't have a clue when it comes to evaluating the quarterback position. You got some guys out there who are defensive linemen. They send them out to scout a quarterback. You got to have guys that play the position, understand the position, know how a quarterback thinks, knows about mechanics, knows about accuracy. Everyone talks about a big, strong arm and can he run. That doesn't work.
Well, you look at Alex Smith right now in his third year with, as Mike said before, his third different offensive coordinator.
Right.
And he misses Norv Turner. Because when Norv Turner was with this team last year, he had 16 touchdown passes and 16 interceptions. The other two bookend years have been awful for him. And he feels the heat of being the number one pick. He said when he got to camp the first time, half the team stopped to see what he could do at all times. He said, I'm trying to lose that. I'm trying to get to the cut it loose mentality. It's hard to play that way, always being the number one guy. But that follows you, Jaws. That follows you.
Well, he'll get a chance after the three and out. The run by Maurice Morris gained a couple of yards. They will punt to Seattle, to San Francisco, excuse me, at the 2-minute warning.
NASN brings you unrivaled coverage of the best sports North America has to offer. Get the best seats in the house for the biggest games in the best leagues 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Watch the NFL from preseason all the way to the playoffs with over 60 regular season games, the postseason, and live coverage of Super Bowl 42 from Phoenix. Get live coverage of every game of the World Series and don't miss an inning of the MLB regular season with up to 260 regular season games and the All-Star Game live. Experience the most comprehensive coverage of the NHL anywhere in Europe with over 200 live regular season games, the 2008 NHL All-Star Game, and the Stanley Cup Finals live. NASN takes you to pit lane in the high-octane world of NASCAR with live Busch Series racing and keeps you up to date with the Nextel Cup and Truck Series with daily episodes of NASCAR Now. Get courtside with the best conferences in NCAA college basketball with a packed schedule of games between the top teams and unrivaled coverage of March Madness. See the power and skill of the finest players in college football with full season and bowl series coverage, including all the BCS games, live. And with all your favorite news, highlights, and analysis shows, including PTI and Around the Horn, you won't miss a minute from any of your favorite sports all season long. Log on to NASN.com now and join the world of NASN, your leader in North American sports.
I'll trade you a Red Sox home jersey and a Rangers t-shirt for that Pirates jacket.
No way! I want that Cardinals hoodie and that Braves away uniform and an item to be named later.
You drive a hard bargain.
Majestic Athletic, the official uniform supplier for all 30 Major League Baseball teams. Available now all over Europe at NASN.com.
From Seattle, Stuart Scott will be here. Chris Berman back in our studios. We have the Toyota Halftime Show coming up. Chris's fastest 3 minutes. And Stuart will have a live conversation with Jimmy Johnson and Jeff Gordon heading to the NASCAR finale at Homestead Sunday on ABC. Jimmy Johnson leading by 86 points in the NASCAR Nextel Cup standings. That hit a Seattle player in the helmet, so a flag is down as the ball comes back to the 35-yard line. Might have been Nico Koudevitis, special teams captain, who interfered with the opportunity to catch the kick for Michael Lewis, the old Saint punt returner, the guy who drove the beer truck and eventually made the Pro Bowl.
By the way, former Arena League player too, Mike. I'd get my opportunity.
Lewis.
Number 53 of the kicking team. Fair catch interference. Be a 15-yard penalty, yes, from the spot of the foul. First down, San Francisco.
So that'll take San Francisco to the 31-yard line, I believe, and give them a great opportunity to get on the board here and keep this a game at halftime.
Get on the board. I want to see a first down.
Don't be greedy now.
Well, you can't get any better field position than this. They have to take advantage of it.
Well, that was probably their largest gain of the night, 15 on the penalty. Marty Aronoff, our stat man in the booth, says absolutely. Against a four-man rush to Frank Gore. Snuffed out by Jordan Babineau speeding forward. No game.
Alex Smith in the speed offense for the 49ers.
Ashley Lalee, the wide receiver at the top. Down as battle in the slot. Former Seahawk Darrell Jackson outside. Smith hit. Ball down with a flag down and recovered by the Seahawks. Darrell Tack comes in and gets it after the pressure by Babineau.
There is no foul on the play. I threw my flag instead of my beanbag. First down, Seattle.
It's an honest mistake. The flag instead of the beanbag. It happens all the time. Often goes unreported.
Well, it's an honest mistake, as you'll see. The mistake made by the protection scheme of the San Francisco 49ers. Unblocked coming in the quarterback, Jordan Babineau. No one laid a hand on him. Whack, that's what happens to your quarterback. This 49er offense is completely out of sync. Totally. They're missing blitzes. They're missing pickups. The quarterback's getting beat up.
From the 39, Seattle has no timeouts and 73 seconds to try to make something happen. Hasselbeck completes the pass to Marcus Pollard, the tight end, 2 yards shy of the first down, and Seattle will go hurry up here with 1:02 to go. Remember, they're out of timeouts. Hasselbeck coming back under center. Rarely uses the shotgun, although 4 shotgun snaps in the first half tonight. On the run throw, right back to
the former Lions tight end Pollard, who gets it to the 42 of the Niners. This snap should come right around 30 seconds. Hasselbeck runs it. They have no timeout, so they're going to
scramble
back to the line. From here, a field goal would be 54 yards.
No need to panic. Just spike the ball.
And they'll have a third down play coming up. They're trying to get 12 men on the field for San Francisco. And they did. If they're going to kill the ball and they have no timeouts, why are you subbing on defense?
I have no idea, Mike.
Can you imagine a worse half?
No,
the defense had 12 men in the field. That's a five-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Seattle has 16 first downs. San Francisco has none. The 49ers had 0 first downs. The last team in the regular season to go an entire first half without a first down. The Jets ended the 2005 season against the Patriots. Remember, in the playoff game last year, Kansas City did not have a first down at Indianapolis on wild card weekend. But in the regular season, it has been almost 2 years since. Now Josh Brown comes out with no timeouts left, 12 seconds to try a 49-yard field goal. And a marker is down. Brown made it with about 5 yards to spare. They may need those 5 yards here. Mike Holmgren is going to be
false start
uptight.
Offense number 65. That's a 5 yard penalty. Repeat first down.
That's Chris Spencer, who's normally the center, but on kicks he's in protection. Boone Stutz is the deep snapper.
That was the bitter beer face commercial on Mike Holmgren.
Second time a penalty has nullified a field goal.
6 points.
And now because of that, Nate Clemens goes back to try to return a short field goal. And Seattle made its coverage or its blocking team aware of the fact that Clemens is back. This is a 54-yard field goal. Career long is 58. Right over the pipe, but on the wrong side. And short, no good, as Clemens tried to go up and get it. So with 7 seconds left, San Francisco will take over at its own 36. Alex Smith hasn't had much time, hasn't had much help. Had one chance early, Ron.
Yeah, this was the overthrow early in the game. And then pressure. Did not have much of a chance. They're not picking it up. He's not reading the blitz, getting the ball out of his hand. It's been a very disorganized, to say the least, 49ers offense here in the first half.
You get a chance on national television to redeem your season, in which you're completing under 50% of your passes. You get out here and you can't do anything.
He has not been sharp, but he hasn't gotten any help.
No time, nothing. Nothing.
And I thought coming into this game, it would be a Frank Gore game. I thought they would just pound him. The two games last year, 212 yards and 144 yards, and 2 Niner wins over the Seahawks. They've abandoned the run this evening.
They go with the old Big Ben formation to the right for a Hail Mary in the final 9 seconds. Smith will roll out and show us if he can throw it 64 yards to the goal line. A little shy of it. That pass is incomplete as it comes to the ground.
Oh, he got it, Mike. He got it.
The ball came to the ground when he came down.
They're spotting it.
Yep, they are. Mike Nolan's asking for 1 second left, so ruled on the field a completion and a first down, but the half is over.
Got the first down.
Arnez Battle going up to get it. See, it was being pulled away from him.
No, he did not have it, Mike.
Yeah. And the ball is coming out in the ground in front of the guy, and he's saying it's a catch.
I just saw the side
judge. The pass was complete. But time ran out for the half. Completed pass down here. Time ran out for the half.
So they have a first down.
At least they got that going for them, which is good.
17-0 at the half. To the studio, Chris Berman, Toyota Halftime Show.
All right, Michael, thank you very much. And
all right.
The Killers are Monday Night Musicians as we begin the third quarter here in Seattle. Michelle Tafoya, Susie Culber on the sideline, Mike Tirico, Ron Jaworski, Tony Kornheiser up here in the booth. 17-0, a dominant first half as Alex Smith and the Niners credited with one first down. I think incorrectly because they missed the call at the end of the half, but still Mike Nolan's team a world of hurt against Holmgren's crew trying to go to 5-4 and maintain their one game lead atop the NFC West. And they try an onside kick to start the quarter with Nedney, who's a very effective onside kicker.
But I got it.
C.J. Wallace of Seattle may have pulled it away. C.J. Wallace did a great job on his back of reaching his right arm out and taking it back. So San Francisco, which has pulled this trick multiple times, including against Seattle, almost pulled it off to start the third quarter. Watch for Wallace, 39 for the Seahawks.
Yeah, Nedney did an excellent job. That ball is free right there.
Right there. He gets that right arm in there and is able to wrestle it away from the San Francisco player who had his hands around it.
Give him some credit, though, for trying to turn the game around.
Well, San Francisco recovered the onside kick to start the second half in the first meeting between these teams, October 7th at San Francisco. Last year, they tried another trick play. So the wrinkles have been there and worked before, but unable to do it there. So Seattle takes over from midfield. You want to try an onside kick? We're going to try a home run ball. Incomplete from Morris coming out of the backfield as Hasselbeck got knocked down. Ron and Tony, the first half numbers all spelled domination.
17-1 on first downs. They disputed first down, as we believe.
Yeah, and look at that 42. I had to put the big beam on that one. 42 passing yards, and I think it came like on that last play, before the half.
And just so you know, as we mentioned, how it was called on the field, that play was not reviewable last play of the first half because it did not involve a score. So those wondering.
I was one.
From midfield, it's second down, five in the pattern, and one of them is Leonard Weaver. The fullback gains 14. First down at the 36. Here's Michelle Tafoya.
Well, Mike, Seattle's pass to run ratio in the first half was 2-1. Mike Holmgren told me that ratio probably wouldn't change here in the third quarter. He said, we'll do what we have to do. Matt Hasselbeck shouldn't have to throw it 27 more times as he did in the first half. He said, we'll do what we have to do. Hopefully here in the third quarter, we'll do some good things, and that'll take the stress off of Matt in the fourth quarter, guys.
And again, Michelle, for those tuning in, Sean Alexander, career low 3.3 yards per carry this year, out with the knee and ankle injuries that he suffered against Cleveland last week. Morris lost the football. It's free. It's right under him, and he couldn't get his hands free to dig it out, and the Niners may have taken it away. Abrea Franklin, the nose tackle, started it, and the Niners come up with their first turnover of the night. So they couldn't come up with the onside kick when it was free, but get the recovery on the Maurice Morris fumble.
And he tries to jump to the outside, and the ball just squirts out between his ribs and his elbow. The 49ers recover. Let's see if they can get it jump started on offense.
Miller Lite.
Cubs and Yankee fans are like oil and water. Cubs and White Sox fans at the same dinner table? Bad idea. Despite their differences, fans do have one thing in common. Their heroes all wear Majestic Athletic, the official uniform supplier for all 30 Major League Baseball teams. Available now all over Europe at NASN.com.
This season, NASN brings you more live college football action than ever before. Start your weekend off with the guys on ESPN's College Game Day Live as the crew broadcasts from a different college campus each week and leads you into up to three live football games each Saturday. Chill out on Sundays with more first-run games and catch up on all the weekend scores and highlights on College Football Final. And when things really start heating up, we've got top conference championship games and all the major bowl games live, including every BCS game and the national championship live from New Orleans. And if that's not enough, we bring you special midweek live games from ESPN and all the latest news, previews, and predictions every weekday with College Football Live, a 30-minute wrap-up show to keep you up to date. NASN is your only place to see all this great college football action. log on to NASN.com for the latest schedules and information.
ESPN's Monday Night Football is brought to you by UPS. What can Brown do for you? IBM. When you're ready to stop talking innovation and start doing, visit IBM.com/do. Miller Lite. For award-winning taste, there's no debate. Miller Lite. Good call. And Taco Bell. Think outside the bun.
Back here, right on the south edge of the big buildings in downtown Seattle. Next door, it's Safeco Field. Home of the Mariners. Niners take over from their own 38-yard line. And back to Gore with a lead block. Let's just line up and just see how angry we are. To the 44, and here's Susie.
Mike, I asked Mike Nolan, how do you find a spark for your team? And at first he shook his head and said, I don't know, but followed up with, watch very closely and you'll see. The one thing that this team doesn't need help with is staying upbeat. When you talk to the veterans, they say there is no finger pointing. They rally around each other. But the thing this team lacks is a certain sort of edginess. And that's something you need to win, a balance and an edge.
Mike Nolan over there talking to the defense as the offense picked up six. They tried it with that onside kick, didn't get the recovery, did get the turnover. Gore was tripped up by his own man, thus able to keep going and get out to midfield, and that's yardage sufficient for a first down.
You know, Mike Susie said, we'll see it the second half. What I am seeing right now is attitude running the football. It's not any fancy counter tray. It's get a body on a body and whip the guy across from you. That's the attitude running we saw in the first two plays. Obviously, as we saw Mike Nolan on the sidelines, he is not a happy camper right now. The defensive possession the last time, they made mental mistakes. They can't make those mistakes. They're able to escape.
The 49er team that's lost its last six games has deflected and incomplete as Darrell Tapp went to chase it down for the tip and the pick.
George, you talk about attitude. The attitude that the 49ers had coming into this season was they could be a very good team, maybe win the division. They'd gone from four wins in 2005 to seven in 2006. They had young, good players in Smith and Gore. They thought they'd make a move. This is the DNA there. When you get a good young passer, you think he's Montana. You get a good runner, you think he's Roger Craig. You get a coach who does well, you think he's Bill Walsh. The flashy expectations that accrue to teams in San Francisco make them overrate themselves because they expect greatness immediately.
Second and 10. Smith escapes, rushes to the 45. He gains a half dozen. Greg Terrell helps bring him down. We'll have third and four coming up.
Tony, football is the consummate team game. 11 guys on every single play working together. Yes, you may have the quarterback you think is the next Steve Young, Joe Montana, and we'll have Steve here a little bit later to talk about that. You may think you have the outstanding running back, but you got to have all the components, all the dimensions.
Well, I think what they didn't realize is it's a lot harder to go from seven wins to 10 than from four to seven. But that was the expectation in San Francisco for this team.
Third and four, you see everybody playing defense, all 11. Now Russell peels back. Smith hitting the knee as he throws deep. Incomplete. He had to get it out of there quick as the pressure was coming. And trying to get it deep down the field for Darryl Jackson. Fourth down and a punt.
The read was correct. He read the blitz. Alex did a good job of getting the ball out of his hand. He had Darryl Jackson with a step on the corner. There's got to be a little more air under the football. Allow the receiver to adjust. The ball is too flat. Got to have some air under it. Another miscue on the throw. The wrong throw.
Andy Lee, the punter, is not back to normal 15 yards. He's back 10 yards. So let's see if there's a fake coming here. And he flexes out. Battle came back under center to take a snap. Trying to force the Seahawks into a motion penalty, right? Michael Robinson, I beg your pardon, and they don't get it. Good little wrinkle, didn't matter.
That's an outstanding job by the Seattle Seahawks, being aware of the gimmick play.
I mentioned Arnaz Battle, who we mentioned earlier was a quarterback at Notre Dame, and those of you who watch the Niners know this, but nationally a reminder, Michael Robinson, the personal protector who snuck up in there under center, was a quarterback at Penn State in their resurgent year a couple of seasons ago. Ran for 860 yards, threw 17 touchdowns. Now back to conventional Lee. Fair caught by Burleson, who lost it but out of bounds, and Seattle will take over right around their own 20-yard line. 3.5 gone by, third quarter, all Seahawks.
From the people who brought you College Game Day and the worldwide leader in sports comes the biggest thing to hit college football in years, College Football Live, a new way to get your fix every weekday with breaking news, exclusive interviews, and packed full of previews and predictions. Get ahead of the game every weekday with College Football Live on NASN.